So, hi people, Vrinda here from Tulsi Guidance, and today I am inviting you to the unboxing of this amazing deck, the Oracle of Rama. A beautiful deck to unbox in the Diwali time. We all know Diwali is so strongly associated with the homecoming of Rama, and let's see what this card deck brings to us, what message it brings to us. So first I'll unbox this card with all of you, I'll show you the entire deck, and then we will do a single card reading and see what message Ram wants to give to all of you. I don't have any idea what I'm going to see inside, and yes, here I see a beautiful book, the Oracle of Rama. The colors are also so nice. We all know purple color kind of gives us the spiritual connection. It's got that nice shade of purple, very subtle, not very strong, and the whole book has the verses in this. Wow, let's see what the cards are all about. And yes, the cards of the Oracle of the Rama. If you put this card away. Now these are a set of 56 cards. This is like, you know, what we have here is 56 cards. And let's see what these cards are all about. Now here they have given me some instructions how to, oh wow, they've added a special card to give the instructions. So now when we see the cards, like what I see here is, when I'm seeing in the book, no, they've given us an understanding that totally the deck is 58 cards, but then there are 49 cards and then there are some divine guides. They have divided the whole thing into 7 chapters, the cards, and then there are divine guides. So what I see here is, like there are these few cards, no, which are only about the divine guides, and we have Hanuman, we have Shatrughan, we have Bharat, we have Rama, we have Sita, and we have Lakshmana. So these could be our divine guides. So if any of our question brings out this card, we will know what that is going to tell us. And then we have these cards here, the rest of them. They have a proper, like you can see the different colors that they've given. They've divided the deck, you know, like into these 7 chapters. So they have divided into 7 chapters, and as I see in the book, the chapter 1 is about the great story begins, and that I think is all about how Rama's childhood was. And then we go deep into the forest, that's this one, deep into the forest. And then we have opponents and allies, and that's our third one, that's opponents and allies. Then we have calm within the storm, and that one is calm within the storm. And then we have the final challenges, that is this one. And then we have the great reign of Rama, and that is this one. And then we have the signs, omens, warnings, that is this one. So wow, this is like a very detailed deck, huh? This has a very, very, very different energy than I have seen with the usual oracle cards. The readings in this are going to be quite elaborate, I guess. We will do a one card reading today just to get an, you know, kind of a connection to the cards. But I think to get proper answers to something, this can be a very, very, very contributing deck. Because, and when we do some kind of 3-card or 7-card readings, we can get very detailed answers with this deck, is what I'm sensing. The way they have divided the whole thing, and you know, the way they are also giving, the whole card has so much of a detailed text given. It's not only that just an image has been given, they have given a lot of understanding of the whole thing. They've given here that how you can, what verse to read, what indication is coming, what favorable situation for small gains can happen, what, you know, how you can work to abandon a friend, to turn from God. So guys, what I can sense here is, you know, how they have done this is, like, when we have to ask a question. So when I'm going to give you a one card reading, no, what I'll be doing is I'll take out one card from this part, the 49 cards, and one card from this, and then we'll connect and see what message is coming to us. So these 7 cards and these 49 cards, the combination makes it a card deck of 58. I just looked at the instructions again, and this is what you're going to do. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a 3 card reading for you guys, and you guys can choose your query or your question and then see what guidance comes to you all. So now here is the reading for everyone. Like, look at these 3 dark cards. Like, look at very closely. Look at the diya, look at the agarbatti stand, and look at the bell. Ask for a question. Ask whatever is in your mind, what you would like. Ask Rama to give you a guidance on whatever issue you would like to get a guidance on. If no specific thing, you can always just ask him to guide you for whatever he would like to give you a message on. And then concentrate on these 3 items and this pile of cards. So once you concentrate, you can even pause it till you get an awareness that whether group A is connecting to you, group B is connecting to you, or group C is connecting to you. And once you have that understanding, what is, you know, your choice, make that choice, and then you can always use the timestamp and just go to your reading. You can just read about the particular group that your connect comes to. If you connect to more than one or more than 2 cards, that's also fine. You can, you know, read both the, or you can, you know, hear the both the readings. So once you've made your choice, let's go ahead and see what the guidance is coming to you. So this is the group A. This is the group A cards that are coming. The divine guide that's coming for group A is Rama, and this is the message that's coming for group A. Now I won't be able to show you these cards very clearly, but I have studied the cards, and I'll give you the reading in gist. You know, I'll be giving you a short gist of what the message is coming for you. For group A people, basically the message that's coming is that Rama is the one, God Ram is the one you should turn to and ask for him for whatever query you've asked. There is a lot of stress that you are sensing in your life, and there is a lot of difficult times that you've gone through, and whatever difficulties you've gone through, you're almost coming to the end of it by just surrendering to the divine. This card very clearly tells you that, you know, even if sorrow comes to you, if you surrender to the divine, it all just gets away. And here the divine guide that is coming for group A is Lord Rama himself. You know, the Supreme Lord Rama himself is coming to you. So basically, people who are, I sense the group A people are the ones who have gone through a lot of misfortune or troubled times or difficult times, and they have been very stressed out over something. And this is the time now, if you surrender to the divine, whoever you consider the divine, whatever is your connect, and you can just surrender there, and you can start to see the end of that difficult phase and a lot of new things to open up for you. Divine grace can do the impossible. It can create more ease and joy for you. So basically, if you are experiencing misfortune, turn towards the divine and the grace will come, is clearly what group A is being told. Okay, so this is the group B. The group B card that is coming is, once again, like I said, I cannot really show you the cards because the print is quite small, but I have studied the cards, and I'll just give you the gist of the reading here, what message Lord Rama is giving you and what divine guide is coming for you. So here what I'm saying is that it's time for a lot of inner growth for you. This is the time that you will see a lot of deep inner growth to continue and, you know, get you out of that outer concerns. A favorable atmosphere will will just get created around you. And interestingly, I can also see that the guide that has come for you is Shatrughna. And Shatrughna is, he kind of exemplifies a strong and determined guardian who protects his people from conflicts, challenges. His qualities are of, you know, watchfulness and persistence. So Shatrughna is somebody who is going to watch over you, and he's also going to contribute you to your inner growth. So Group B people, whatever question you're asking, whatever query is there in your mind, whatever you're trying to ask, the guidance that's coming to you is call upon Shatrughna and take his blessings. And what is showing up for you guys is that you are definitely on more of an inner growth path, and whatever has been your query, it's being watched over by your angels and your spirit guides, and you are definitely going to create that with ease. Whatever it is that is bothering you, you will be coming out of it. In fact, I don't even sense that something is really bothering you. It's just that whatever work that you've been doing, it's going to be very favorable for you. So Group B, a very favorable timing for you for whatever query has been on your mind. So this is for the Group C, that the message is coming. And what I see here, this card, I mean, again, I'll say that I cannot really show you guys the card because the imprint is quite small, but I have seen the gist of the card and I'm just giving you the reading. I'll let you know what message is coming for you. So here, what I can see for Group C, whatever query that you have, whatever ask that you have, or whatever you're questioning from the deck, what the answer is coming to you is that there will be someone who's going to show up in your space. There's going to be someone who's going to, like, maybe a feminine energy, or maybe somebody who has a strong feminine energy. It could be a female or it could be a male with a strong feminine energy, and somebody who's going to show up in your space, who's going to create more ease for you, and who's going to create the next step for you. Very clearly, this card is talking about, you know, how the companion to Lord Rama had created more ease in his journey. And wonderfully, when I see the guide that's also coming for you is Lakshmana. And as we all know, Lakshmana is considered Lord Rama's brother. He's considered one of the best confidant or friend or companion that you can ask for. He left everything and went with his brother just to support him. It was not his journey. It was something he just went along to support. So he is your guide here. So you can always invoke that energy of finding that confidant who can actually be a contribution to you. So for Group C people, the guidance is very clear that it's whatever your query was or whatever your question was, the guidance for you is get that person who will be a confidant, or who will be, you know, who will be getting you that support system, the friend or the mentor or the, you know, somebody who just supports you all the way, and that is really going to be contributing to your query. Whatever you've been asking for and whatever solution you're looking for, the answer lies in that person showing up in your space. It could be somebody with a feminine energy and a female, there's a very strong chance of that. You know, somebody who has a more spiritual and connect along with a strong presence in the worldly power also, but a very strong spiritual connect also that person will have. So honor that and be prepared to, you know, travel with that person. Maybe you'll have to give up a little bit of your inhibitions and stuff. Maybe it might not be exactly the person you're looking for, or maybe it's somebody you have some kind of resistance with. Just get open to that and be willing to receive. So go on and hear the card, the reading again. And like I said, these are very, very, very detailed cards. It's totally a new thing for me also. I've never seen cards like this ever in my life. First time I've come across a deck like this. And it's been wonderful doing this reading for you guys. Of course, like I said, it's the first time. So for me also, some things are very new in this. But that's the fun. There's always fun to receive from something new and see what shows up. I'm sure I'm going to create some very beautiful readings from this and beautiful guidances, because what I can see, the combination of these cards can give us very detailed answers to our queries. So watch out for some wonderful readings getting created in the future in my WhatsApp broadcast, and I'll see what, you know, I can do for you guys with this deck. Because what I see is the way they've divided the whole thing by giving you the divine guide who can be with you and the detailed information in these cards. And then the book itself has so much detail, like, you know, the way they'll tell you which section to go to, and then the section details are given here and all that. So it's really amazing the kind of detail this reading is giving. And I think many of you who have done readings with me and who have done classes with me, I keep telling that I'm one person who connects a lot to the text. a lot of messages for me from my angels, my spirit guides, my divine comes to me from text. And this much text, you know, my God, this is like so much information. The amount of information they will give me in my readings is just so wonderful. So yeah, I would love to create more with this deck, and let's see what else is possible. And before I wind up, I'll definitely want to say I'm in love with the colors and the print of this card. The quality of the printing and the colors is so beautiful. The texture of the paper is so amazing. The way the whole thing has been designed is so amazing. And yes, even the concept of the card is so different and so beautiful. I'm really happy that I've been able to, you know, get these cards for myself. And that too just on a whim, you know, I just saw it, got attracted and got it. And best part, I'm doing this reading, I'm doing this unboxing just a day before Diwali. We've already entered that energy of Diwali and I'm doing this for you guys. And I feel so blessed. Thank you all for watching. Thank you all for going through this. And I'll again say, excuse me if I was fumbling somewhere, because it was a very new thing for me also. And it was a little beyond my comfort zone. But that's where the growth lies, right? Getting out of the comfort zone. It's more fun for all of us. So let's see what else is possible. And a very, very, very happy Diwali to all of you. A prosperous new year. May we all create whatever we desire to create in our lives with the divine guidance and the divine energies. As I have told you guys, I have a broadcast, WhatsApp broadcast. If any of you are not on it, you would like to get added to it, you can always send me a text on the number given below, and you can always get added to it. In that broadcast, I create many special offers of card readings, and I keep giving healing tips also. And any feedbacks, any suggestions, you can do it in the comment section, or you can send me a personal text. Anything else you would like to see on this channel, please recommend. We would love to give you more and more stuff so that we all can grow together. So let's see what else is possible. Bye.